Welcome children to another session of our history class. Children, we work according to the calendar. We go according to the days, that is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. And Sunday is the holiday. So this is how we go. So history will tell us how these dates and calendars came into existence. Who made the calendars? Now let's see what is an almanac. Almanac is an annual calendar. It highlights important dates and statistical information such as astronomical data and tide tables. So this is an annual calendar which is known as almanac. Now the present day calendar that we have, where we have 365 days and in the leap year we have 366 days. As you know, it is 365 and 1/4 year, 1/4 day every year. And this 1/4, after every 4 years, we have a leap year where there is one day that increases in the month of Feb. That is, we have 28 days in Feb, while in the leap year we have 29 days. Now let's see who invented this kind of a calendar. The Gregorian calendar. The Gregorian calendar was introduced in October 1582 by Pope Gregory XIII. It was named after Pope Gregory XIII. It is a modification of the Julian calendar. So the previously it was the Julian calendar that was in existence, but in 1582, Pope Gregory XIII, he discovered the Gregorian calendar. Now here are the days that we come across, that is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and the seventh day is Sunday. Now there are 4 or 5 weeks in a month. Sometimes we have 4 weeks and sometimes we have 5 weeks in 1 month. 12 months make a year. So when 4 or 5 weeks make a month and then 12 months together make 1 year. A year has 365 days, while a leap year has 366 days. A leap year comes after every 4 years. So after every 4 years, one day increases, and in every leap year, after every 4 years, a day increases, and from 365 it becomes the 366th day in that fourth year. 7 months have 31 days each and 4 months have 30 days each. Find out their names. It should be noticed that February has 28 days. Now you know that 7 months have 31 days and 4 of the months in a year have 30 days. Now you have to find out which months have 31 days and which months have 30 days. It should be noticed that February has 28 days, but in the leap year it has 29 days. So the 29th day of February is known as the leap day and the month is termed as the leap month. So this is how the year goes and every month and day is counted. Now here we have the leap year calendar. So you can see, children, here that we have the 29th day in February, that is in the leap year. Now the structure of the Gregorian calendar goes in this way. So the first month is the January, which has 31 days. Second, we have the February, which normally has 28 days and in the leap year it has 29 days. In March it has 31 days. In April it has 30 days. So it goes on this way and we have 7 months that have 31 days and 4 months have 30 days with 1 month of February which has 28 or 29 days. The Gregorian calendar is a solar calendar. It is globally the most widely used civil calendar. So this is what the Gregorian calendar is all about. So I hope you have learned how this calendar came into existence and how we are calculating our days, months and years according to the Gregorian calendar. So learn about this thoroughly and then we will move up to the Saka calendar. We'll later on learn with the national calendar which India accepts, and it is in this country that we accept the Saka calendar, and we go along this calendar and all the festivals are taken according to this calendar. So it's all for now. Bye bye.